In recent years, an amazing green revolution has been quietly taking place in China's vast deserts. In the second half of 2024, a 3,046-kilometer green ecological barrier in China's desert area finally completed the final splicing. According to U.S. satellite remote sensing images, this has become the world's longest green ecological barrier around the desert, which can be regarded as a great achievement in the confrontation between humans and nature. Many people wonder how this green barrier of more than 3,000 kilometers was built. According to my investigation, in order to prevent the expansion of desertification, China has invested about 8,000 advanced sand control robots. These robots are powerful and can not only automatically plant seedlings, but also improve soil structure, precise irrigation, and complete the entire process of tree planting. According to the staff settings, 160 seedlings need to be planted per acre, and these smart devices can complete it in just 20 minutes, which is more than 10 times more efficient. Once this news was released, many countries with serious desertification expressed their desire to introduce this set of sand control technology and equipment. They believe that China's achievements will promote global desertification control and change the future desert ecological environment. So, in today's video, we're going to take a deep dive into how China's sand control robots are changing desertification. If you like our video content, please click to subscribe to my YouTube channel so that you can receive all our latest video content. Now, let's get into today's topic. Before the 21st century, China was one of the countries facing the most serious land desertification in the world. According to surveys, the area of desertified land in China at that time had reached an astonishing 2.61 million square kilometers, almost one-third of the country's total land area. Among these deserts, the Taklamakan Desert is undoubtedly the most daunting. This desert, known as the Sea of Death, covers an area of 330,000 square kilometers, equivalent to the entire land area of Japan. What's more terrifying is that it is the second largest mobile desert in the world. Sand dunes can move dozens of meters overnight, and the highest sand dunes are even more than 200 meters, equivalent to the height of a 100-story building. The Taklamakan Desert is extremely mobile. Whenever strong winds blow up sand and dust, it not only causes serious damage to agricultural production in surrounding provinces, but also directly threatens the normal operation of transportation. Faced with this seemingly unstoppable natural disaster, China began to address this problem as early as the last century and launched the Three Norths Shelter Belt System construction project, planning to curb the spread of desertification by building a green barrier around the Taklamakan Desert. In order to achieve this goal, the Chinese government called on nearly 200,000 workers to participate in the sand control project and even mobilized the army to go to the desert area for ecological construction. In the early stages, people used an extremely primitive but effective method to fix the quicksand, burying hay 15 to 20 centimeters in the sand, leaving only 20 centimeters on the surface, in this way to reduce the mobility of sand dunes. At the same time, Chinese scientists have also specially developed drought-resistant plant varieties and planted them in desert areas. These drought-resistant plants grow tenaciously in harsh environments and gradually begin to restore the desert ecology. As of 2010, the afforestation project has been implemented for more than 40 years, and China has successfully greened the desert area to more than 100 million mu. It is worth mentioning that desert control methods are effective, but the resources invested are also huge. The first is the problem of manpower. Since most of the desert areas being treated are far away from cities, transportation is extremely inconvenient, and the environment is harsh. Those involved in desert control can only lay an average of about 300 square meters of grass squares every day. Secondly, there is huge pressure on capital costs. Taking desert control as an example, the cost of saplings and water sources alone is as high as about $210 US, plus labor costs of about $100 per acre. Based on the scale of China's desertified land area, controlling only one-third of the desert already requires astronomical amounts of capital investment. Faced with these difficulties, China has begun to explore the possibility of replacing labor with mechanical equipment in recent years. In 2024, China's automatic tree planting machinery has been put into use and has achieved great results. So, what exactly happened? In fact, as early as 2021, China has developed a desert prevention and control robot and started experiments in desert areas. With the success of the experiment, China has successively developed more than 150 types of advanced machinery and equipment specifically used to prevent and control desertification in recent years. As of 2025, a total of 8,000 desert control robots have been deployed in desert areas, and the total afforestation area of the Three North Protective Forest Project area has reached 480 million acres. According to my understanding, these robots use cluster local joint control technology. Every five robots form a group and work together to complete the tree planting task of approximately 180 acres in one day. Each robot can operate according to set planting requirements. It can plant 160 saplings per acre, and the whole process only takes 20 minutes. Calculating this, using these robots to plant trees can plant a tree every 10 seconds, which is more than 10 times more efficient than traditional manual methods. What is even more surprising is that these sand control robots are equipped with an artificial intelligence-based visual analysis system, which can accurately identify which areas are suitable for tree planting and can automatically plan the best path to easily avoid obstacles such as sand dunes and gullies. In addition, they also have very powerful performance. Not only do they have strong computing power, but they can also work stably in extreme environments, such as high temperature, strong ultraviolet radiation, and even sandstorms. Their design is also very particular. With its own cooling system, sturdy and durable body, and advanced power system, they can carry out tree planting tasks 24 hours a day. Their leader is a puncher, powered by an engine. The drill can make a 1 meter deep hole in the desert in a very short time, and then use a group of robots to inject water and plant seedlings. The most noteworthy thing is that these sand control robots can not only move freely on slopes, but also walk easily on slopes within 25 degrees, and can even work steadily on slopes within 12 degrees. What's more amazing is that with the help of precise positioning technology and irrigation-free seedling technology, the survival rate of trees planted by these robots is as high as 70% to 80%. You know, in the past sand control projects, such a survival rate was almost unimaginable. Today, as China vigorously promotes the research and development of mechanized sand control and sand fixation, the proportion of sand control and afforestation with mechanical equipment in the Three North's Shelter Belt project has reached nearly 50%. You know, the average price of a small sand control machine is only about 30,000 yuan, but its work efficiency is more than 10 times that of manual labor, and it can also reduce the cost of sand control and sand fixation by more than 40%. The local tree planting staff lamented that in the past, it was all done manually, and a team of three people could only complete the tree planting task of 2 acres of land a day. Now, with the newly developed self-propelled grass grid sand barrier mechanical equipment, one person can complete 20 acres of grass grid suppression in a day. By the end of 2023, China has built a 2,761 kilometer green sand barrier around the Taklamakan Desert. By the end of 2024, this green barrier finally filled the last piece of the puzzle, and the 3,046 kilometer long barrier formed a green chain along the edge of the desert, marking the full realization of the locking edge closure of the Taklamakan Green Sand Barrier Project. According to data from China's Forestry Department, the Three North's project area has completed a total of 480 million mu of afforestation tasks and has also managed 1.28 billion mu of degraded grassland. This key governance area is undergoing a historic transformation, from the past sand advancing and people retreating to today's green advancing and sand retreating. What is even more proud is that in the past 30 years, the area of artificial oases around the Taklamakan Desert has expanded from 65,000 square kilometers to 100,000 square kilometers, an increase of about 54%. In addition to the Taklamakan Desert, these sand control robots developed by China have also played a huge role in deserts across the country. According to statistics, China has planted more than 68 billion trees in the desert, improving a total of about 4.45 billion mu of desert land, bringing new life to the once barren land. In order to consolidate the results of sand control, China has also implemented close protection measures, covering as many as 26.58 million mu of desertified land, successfully achieving effective management of more than half of the country's manageable desertified land. In addition, China has established more than 50 comprehensive demonstration areas for sand prevention and control, as well as 26 desert ecosystems, providing strong support for sand control with science and technology. Now, China's achievements in desert control have been highly recognized worldwide. Since joining the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification in 1994, China has been an active promoter and contributor in this field. Through unremitting efforts, China has taken the lead in achieving the United Nations goal of zero global land degradation by 2030. Of course, China has also actively cooperated with other countries and regions to share its experience and technology in desert control with the world. In particular, at the 16th Conference of the Parties to the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification held at the end of 2024, China's achievements in desert control once again became the focus. The conference was held in Riyadh, the capital of Saudi Arabia, and is the largest conference of the parties to date. China also took this opportunity to fully display the Three Norths project and the battle against desertification abroad for the first time. During the meeting, China shared its technology and experience in desert control with dignitaries and experts from more than 100 parties. In fact, as early as the Secretariat of the United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification, representatives from Mongolia, Saudi Arabia, the United Arab Emirates, Uzbekistan, Iraq, South Africa, Morocco, Somalia, Yemen, and other countries have come to China to investigate and learn about the latest progress of Chinese companies in sand control technology innovation. Experts and scholars from many countries said that China's sand control robots have injected new hope into global desertification control. You know, desertification is not only a major ecological challenge that China has faced for a long time, but also a serious problem that concerns the world, especially in the Middle East and Africa, where the problem of land desertification is more prominent. The tree planting conditions and ecological environment in these areas are actually very similar to those in China's Taklamakan Desert. Today, the desert tree planting robot developed by China is like a nuclear weapon in the field of environmental governance, which has subversively improved the efficiency and survival rate of sand control. For many countries in the Middle East, such technology is exactly the solution they urgently need. To not miss out on our future projects and news updates, please make sure you subscribe to our channel and turn on notifications. We will continue to provide you with more exciting and interesting content.